You and I both know that video content is such an integral part of any great social media content strategy. But video creation just doesn't come very easily to everyone. In fact, it probably doesn't come easily to most people. But then you look at people on YouTube and Instagram and TikTok who have that mileage in video creation and they make it look super easy. But in reality, it's a really daunting process for most business owners who might not have the budget or the resources to have 10 or 20 people working behind the scenes to make things look really seamless and easy. So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you a really cool tool called Descript that's gonna make it really, really easy for you to take one piece of video content, whether it's 40 seconds or 40 minutes, and turn it into various pieces of content for your entire online presence. So you can turn it into a square video post, a vertical video post with your fancy captions already automatically embedded in there. And you'll also get an automatic transcript that you can then publish as a blog post or turn it into a newsletter. And what's more is that you can do all of this in less than 20 minutes, even if you're a complete beginner in the world of video creation. And now, just before we dive into Descript, if you want more tips on how to create a bigger impact with your social media content, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on your notifications so you can be the first to know whenever I release a new video. And if you stay till the end of the video, I'm gonna be showing you how you can use Descript to create awesome audiograms just like this one. For those of you who maybe have really awesome content to share with your people, but you're just not comfortable getting in front of the camera yet, but you want to leverage the power of video. This could be a really, really cool thing for you to use and for you to share that advice with your audience without having to get on camera. And now, if you're ready, let's get started. As soon as you actually install your Descript app, you'll be able to jump straight in. And the one thing that will be in there is your Descript tutorial, which is going to walk you through step by step through all of the different tools and functions that you need within this tool. So we're not going to get too much into that at the moment. We're just going to go into how these different functions can be used for your social media projects. So at the moment, we don't have anything in here. I'm going to jump in and just select my quick 40 second clip just so I can show you a few functions that you can use for your social media posts. Now, keep in mind, some of your videos might be long. Some of my videos in here are quite long, you know, 10, 15, 20 minutes. So this might take a little bit longer. So don't panic if it's feeling like it's a bit glitchy just because the file is a bit longer. So transcribing and importing is just going to take as long as it takes for your video size. But it's going to basically ask you how you want to transcribe your file. And some voices and some accents as well will always be a little bit easier to transcribe automatically. But I say that you should give it a shot before you use any of the paid transcription options, because I find it to be very, very spot on with its transcription of my videos specifically. So give it a shot. And it's also quite easy to edit because it doesn't pop it out in, you know, line by line with what you're saying, like a lot of other transcription services. I find it a lot easier to edit my text this way because it's, you know, a little bit more familiar. It's like you're editing a blog post, but you're really just editing kind of what you said. So definitely play through the actual clip and see if you need to make any changes before you put in things like your captions. And you can literally just come in here and say, all right, this should be a comma, not a period. And it's going to then capitalize things based on the changes you're making. And it's also going to make the changes for your actual timed captions down here. So that's the first bit. You want to make sure that this is correct. Also, because you might be repurposing this for a blog post or something else, maybe even a LinkedIn article, if that's something that you're using for your social media strategy. But this is already a really cool function of this tool. The second thing that we want to do is make sure that it's going to have a little bit more real estate on your social media platforms than a horizontal video might. So because we're going to be using this for Instagram in this case, I want to make sure that it's either a square post or maybe a vertical post. So in here, in your composition settings, you can jump in here and say what orientation preset you want to select. So square is already in there if you want to use a square one. Alternatively, you can also jump in here to custom, make sure that you're unlocking this so you can make some changes. And the height for a vertical Instagram post is 1350. And then it makes it a little bit taller there for you to give you a little bit more space. So obviously it's black. That's not ideal. It might really ruin our grid if we've got a beautiful Instagram profile feed. So we want to make sure we're jumping in here. I'm just going to add a few more files so that I can take you through my process here. And I do create my backgrounds inside of Canva, so they're a little bit more advanced. But if you just want to stick with creating stuff inside of Descript, you don't want to jump into too many graphic design tools, all you can do is just highlight the text here. So that would be Command A on a Mac or Control A on a PC, and just say, I actually just want to jump in here, click the plus sign, and maybe add in a rectangle. So that will allow you to stretch this out all the way out. And obviously that is just my brand color. So you want to change that to whatever your hex code is for your brand. And obviously you want this to be behind the video. So just on your timeline over here, let me drag this up a little bit so you can see it a little bit better. You can say, I'm going to move this layer down. So it doesn't actually physically move anything. It's just in terms of its order, it will move it below your video. And the reason we highlighted the whole text is so that it applies it to your entire video. Otherwise, if you just kind of were to, you know, click in and add anything in here, it would only add it to a part of your video. Anytime you want it to be applied to your whole video, it's easier to just highlight the text before adding anything in here. But that is the easiest way to do it. So you don't necessarily have to have any images prepped. But in this case, I do have some prepped. And for those of you who are overachievers with me, you can do the same thing. So you can jump into your media library, and I would add in maybe this background here, drag it in. I highlighted my whole text, so it's going to be applied to my entire project. And in this case, I would probably use a scale function just to be a little bit more precise with where this line is, because I want that to be in the middle of my project. And then the same thing, I would just move that layer down. So I do have this kind of dual color thing going on. But let's say I've done that, I've scaled it, it all looks exactly how I want it, but then I decide that's actually not the file I wanted. I can jump back into Media Library. I know this is the image that I've just used. So instead of doing the same thing with my second background image and having to precisely get it to where I want it, I can actually just jump in here and say, I want to replace this file, and I'm going to choose the right one as long as it's the same dimensions. Otherwise, it can get a bit skewed. But if it's the same dimensions, I can just jump in here and say, actually replace that with this new one. And then it's just going to basically apply the exact same things you've just done to this new image. Now, this image already has a title within it because I've created that as a part of the image, but I'm going to show you how to create a title just within Descript if you don't want to be using your own pre-made Canva templates. It's quite easy to do. But the first thing we want to focus on is your captions. So I'm just going to go ahead and highlight our script again and go into fancy captions, which I love the title of that. I think that is very cool. So it's popped up here. I can't see anything there yet because I haven't started speaking. So you want to make sure you're dragging that over to where you've started speaking so you can see some text. And I'll just drag that down. Now, I'd encourage you to play around with your different fonts and different font styles and sizes, but just make sure that, you know, you're not making things so large that it's going to go by so quickly people can't read it. So you want it to be a good enough size that people don't have to panic while reading it because it's going by a bit too quickly. I myself prefer single line captions, because I think the two lines just make it a bit more text heavy and people don't end up paying attention to the video as much because they're just spending all their time reading. So single line captions work really well for me, and I usually just go with black, but play around with this. You've got different shadows, different strokes, but I find with captions, less is definitely more, because otherwise it can be quite overwhelming for people if you made 17 different changes to it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. It's really, really quite easy. And if you do just use that kind of rectangle solid color background and you want to add a title to it, then you would just go about it the exact same way. I would just Command A and highlight everything and say, I want to add in a beautiful title. So it is going to put it in the middle of your project. So you want to make sure it's in the right spot there. And then that's just a title you would give it that would be consistent. That's not how you spell Facebook. That would be consistent throughout your whole video. So that's not going to change, but while the captions actually will. So that's pretty much it. And I'm going to remove that for now because obviously I've got my own title in there. But just so you know that it works pretty much the same way as when you're placing in the captions there. All right, so I'm going to jump in and just delete my title here. And I would want to make sure I'm playing through this. So you can either hit the space bar to play or play and pause up here. And I would play through everything just to see if things look good. All right, that looks good. One thing I would add is music, because I really don't love the sound of my own voice of that music back in the background when I post this stuff on social media. So I would just go to my media library. And again, I would just highlight this text, because not only is it going to apply it to your whole text, but it's also going to stop it at the end. Whereas if you just drop it, it's going to make it basically the length of the song, and that's a little bit annoying. So I'm gonna drag my music clip here. If you're not quite sure where to find music tracks that are free for you to use, I will add a link to the description below on how you can do this inside of your YouTube channel library, where you can find music that's licensed for you to use for your clips. But that's as easy as that. It's kind of applied it to the whole clip. It's probably gonna be very loud, so let's see. Yeah, that's going to be a bit too loud and you're not going to be able to hear me very much. So I would want to make sure that I'm dragging the volume down and maybe getting to wherever the drop is, because yeah, that's not too bad. I would play around with the track properties and the clip properties there just to make sure that it's quite a soft tone in the background. It's not like overpowering the whole process. And then the last thing I want to make sure of is making sure that this is going to look good in my Instagram feed, because this is a 1350 vertical post, which means that only the square middle bit is going to be shown in my actual feed. So the way to do that is just to use a template that actually has the dimensions on it. So I use these with my students. I've provided them for you inside of the description below as well if you want to try them out. But basically all it is just going to tell you where the dimensions sit. So I'm just going to drop it in. It doesn't have to be applied to the whole video because we're actually going to erase it. I just want to make sure I'm scaling this all the way. And then I would just make sure I'm putting this in the back or just changing the opacity so I can have a really quick look at where things are sitting. So what you want really is for your video might be here, or your video might be the whole square. But for me, it's just a horizontal one here. But this whole bit is going to be visible inside of my feed. And then anything outside of that is only going to be visible to people actually watching the video. So my title and my captions should really be very well within those lines. So just changing the opacity, I can see that my title is good. I'm not going to be able to see anything up here where it says new class. I'm okay with that. But my captions are a little bit maybe too close to this video. So I would just grab my captions and maybe move them down a little bit, because it's going to look a little bit awkward. Yeah, that looks a little bit better. It's a little bit more centered. And I can actually just click on it here and change the positioning slightly using these tools over here, so I don't necessarily have to move it manually. If I want it to be kind of in the center of this bit, because if somebody looks at it as a square image, that's how it's going to look. And then I would just jump in here and delete that track because I don't need it. And then I know for a fact that, you know, people watching this are going to be able to see the whole thing, but on my Instagram profile, I'm going to be able to see this beautiful square. And as promised, just two more cool things that I want to show you, because this is pretty much ready to export now. I would just want to make sure that I'm deleting this. For some reason, this has appeared at the very end of my track. I don't want that there. I want to make sure everything is beautiful and clean and clear and ready for me to export. But one thing I did want to show you is if you want to change your dimensions, but you want to keep this project as is, because you might use this for Facebook, but then for Instagram, you just want a square post. You can jump in here and duplicate this. You want to make sure you're obviously renaming things so you know what's what. But then this is an exact duplicate of everything you've just created. You can jump in here and say, all right, I want this to be just a square one, or I want this to actually be a portrait because I'm going to be doing this for IGTV, because maybe it's a much longer video that you can't just post as a regular Instagram feed post. So you need to actually post this as IGTV. I'll just make sure my background is where it needs to be. Obviously, that's already got the title in there, but if you manually created your title inside of Descript, you would want to make sure you're moving it around, because as you'll see with the fancy captions here, it will move things around based on the dimensions that you've created, but you don't necessarily need your captions to be all the way down there, especially if you're maybe posting a preview of this somewhere. So now you've got your IGTV or your stories or whatever else for your dimensions here. And then you've got your beautiful Instagram post just over here. So now it's time to click on share, and you would just export this as a video, but you could also export it as a GIF if it's like a really short clip. But instead of just exporting as a video, if you maybe aren't super comfortable on camera, I think this is a really, really cool thing to do. Even if you don't have a podcast, it's not limited to people who have audio content out there in the universe. You can literally just upload a voice clip in here and publish it as an audiogram. So even though this obviously has a video attached to it, it could have easily just been a voice clip that I used to kind of share a lesson from something that I wanted my students to know about. And then you can jump in here and just add in an image. So I just added a black and white image of me, so it's not too distracting. This is my brand color here, so you'd want to add in your own brand color. If you had two speakers, you could also add in a speaker label, but I really am just using this for my own purposes. You could also add in your composition title, which obviously for me, I wouldn't necessarily do that here, and then change your styles. So depending on, you know, do you want people to just focus on one word at a time? Because maybe this is just a 15-second quick audio clip, or do you want it to be a little bit more dynamic like these other ones over here? So you can cycle through them and then publish that as an audiogram and then download that to use for social media as well. So having different formats of the same content like this can be a really powerful way for you to test out what your audience is actually responding to on here. And by publishing this, it's also going to allow you to share this link with other people, which is a really, really cool function of this. Because if you do have team members and you want to share the file with them in a really quick and easy way before you actually download it, that can be a really good way of doing it. And then you can just go ahead and download it from there. All right, so for those of you who have learned from me in the past, whether it's through my courses or through this channel, will know that I get like nerdy level of excited about new tools that are not just really powerful, but also really friendly for beginners to use. So they're not sort of excluding beginners from participating in awesome content creation. And I think Descript nails that really, really well, although there are obviously more advanced things to do with it. But I would really encourage you to check out the link to their YouTube channel in the description below so you can keep on learning from them as they're developing new tools, because they're always kind of releasing updates and looking for feedback from their users as well. So make sure to try it out and let me know what you think as well. And as I said in the beginning, I know that video content creation is a serious challenge for so many business owners, and not everyone is comfortable jumping in front of a camera. So I'd love to really hear from you. What's your biggest challenge with creating videos, or what's stopping you from starting this video creation process if it's something that you know can have a really big impact for your business? Let me know in the comments below, and I might just be able to help by creating some future content around the things that you're struggling with. And if you do want to see some of the clips that I've created with Descript in action, you can head on over to my Instagram account to see how you can use these for short videos like this one, or longer videos like this one on IGTV here. Thank you so much for being here. If you liked the video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you can get a notification every time I create a new video on how to make more impact with your online content. Thanks again for being here, and I'll see you in the next one.